Today we have to read Numbers chapter 7. It's quite a long chapter, but actually we can read it very fast because many places is repeated and repeat. Verse 1 to 9 is the first paragraph. He's talking about we live in the center of God. And verse 10 to 83 is every tribe offers it to God. And then verse 84 to the end is the third paragraph. Verse 1, now it came to pass when Moses had finished setting up the tabernacle that he anointed it and consecrated it and is flourishing. So this is the time when the tabernacle finished and let it anointed and consecrated. Anointed the tabernacle and let it consecrated. And also the altar and all the essentials. So that means that all set. That means that the tabernacle can start to use. Everything is ready. Everything already. And on the same day, when the tabernacle was ready, and they have to start to give the offering to God. And they brought their offering before the Lord, 6 covered calves and 12 ovens of cut off. For every two of the leaders and for each one is also, and they presented them before the tabernacle. So the 12 leaders of the tribe, they are the leader. They are the one have to count before. And they have to offer to God. So they know that every two of the leaders have to offer one cart and one ox. So you know that every leader have to offer half cart and half ox. And they presented them before the tabernacle. So that is in the tabernacle of Moses. And the Lord spoke to Moses, saying, accept those from them, and they may be used in doing the work of the tabernacle of meeting, and you shall give them to Levites, to every man according to his surface. So the Lord spoke to Moses that you have to receive all the offering. And Lord told Moses clearly how to distribute. So for the son of Merari, they can get 2 cars and 4 oxen to give the sons of Gershon. So do you remember the sons of Gerson? They are responding for the firebrand. So they have two carts and four oxen. So when the Israelites, they have to move, and the sons of the Gershons, they can put the fibers on the carts. And verse 8, and 4 calves and 8 oxen he gave to the son of the Merari, according to their service. Because they also have to respond for those wounds and those different things, and so they can have 4 carts and 8 oxen. But to the son, verse 9, but the son of the Gohar, he gave none, because there was the service of the holy things which he carried on their shoulders. They give none, the sons of Gohar, because for their service is to carry it by their shoulders. They have to carry the different utensils in the holy place. And they have to carry the ark, the menorah, those things, and those things cannot carry by the cart. So for the sons of Gohar, they have to carry them by their shoulders. So we know that actually the service of the sons of Gohar actually is not simple. It's not easy at all. Actually, they don't know how. Because Moses and the son of the Aaron, they will be wrapped all the utensils in the holy place, in the tabernacles, and actually they cannot see and they cannot touch. They only can carry them on their shoulders. So for this paragraph, actually telling us that we don't have to compare our service to each other's. Nowadays, when we go to Israel, we can see the table, we can see the utensils in the holy place. And when I went to the Israel, I see the table of the bread actually is very big and very tall, and the table is made from wood and wrapped from the gold, and also the menorah, it is made by a piece of gold, and the menorah is also big. Actually, you know, it is not easy for the son of the Gohar to carry them on their shoulders. You know, maybe they move the fiber and the wood is by the cart, but the son of the Kohath, they have to move, they have to carry on their shoulders. If the sons of the Kohath, they complain, they compare, they can say that, how come they can carry them by the cart, but how come we have to carry those things by our shoulders? So actually, we no need to compare because we have a different responsibility. Only we are royal to what we have to do, and God will promote us. So no need to compare our service to other service. We only serve God royally. And God will remember what we have done. So that is the first paragraph. And every two of the leaders have over one cart and one oxen. And verse 10, now the leaders over the dedication offering for the altar when it was anointed, so the leaders over their offering before the altar, for the Lord said. And it becomes the dedication offering for the altar. That means that we have to ready the altar. So those tribe leaders came again. And the tribe leader, they are the role model. Because when the altar is ready, they have to start offering. When those tribe leaders were ready, and the Lord said to Moses, they shall offer the offering one liter each day for the dedication of the altar. Later on, we will understand why that one day by one day. Actually, each tribe leader, actually they offer many things. So it is better for them to offer day by day. For verse 3, they say they brought their offering before the Lord. And here verse 11 say, 1 liter each day. So actually is, is the leader have to offer by himself, but not represent the tribe. So the leader have to offer first, and then the tribe have to offer. So here the tribe leader to do a role model before all the tribes. This chapter is very long, but actually 12 days they repeat what they have done. and for the first day, verse 12, and the one who offered his offering on the first by was Nathan, the son of Ammiudi, from the tribe of Judah. His offering was one silver platter, the weight of which was 130 shekels, and one silver bowl of 70 shekels, according to the shekel of the sanctuary, both of them full of fine flour mixed with oil as a grain offering, one gold pin of 10 shekels full of incense. So here, the first tribe is the tribe of Judah. He had to offer one silver platter, and the weight of which was 130 shekels. For nowadays is 3 point something pounds. And one silver bowl of 70 shekels. For nowadays, the silver bowl is about 1.75 pounds, 3 pounds of the silver platter and 1.7 pounds silver bowl. Both of them full of fine flour mixed with oil as a grain offering, and one gold pen of 10 shekels. Gold is more value than silver. Ten shekels is 0.25 pounds. So that pan is to put the incense. The gold tan is put the incense, is full of incense. Verse 15, one young bull, before the tribe leader have over one oxen already, and now the tribe also have to over one, the tribe leader also have to over one bull, one ram. One bull is mean that a young bull is not yet mature. One bull, one ram, and one male lamb. One ram is a mature ram. And a male lamb is first year. And then two oxen, five male goats, and five male lambs in the first year. So you can count how many animals he offered. One young bull, one ram, one male lamb, two oxen, five rams, five male goats, and five male lambs. So how many totally? 12 animals and five male lambs, 17.
一歲嘅得啦，一歲嘅呢個公羊羔，所以頭先係，咁樣數都啰嗦咯。十二再十七，十七再加五，成廿幾隻嘅咯喎。
More than 20 animals.
所以其實佢哋擺上嘅係絕對唔嘢少嘅。So
actually they have to offer many.
即係十二個族長，唔幫你逐個逐個嚟，一人一人咁。So
how come God say the tribe leader have to over day by day? Because actually is many animals. So that is the tribe leader of Judah to over on the first day. So the order is from Judah. And the second day, Nezrelite, the son of Sula, leader of Issachar. They are the second tribe. The first day is Judah. The second day is Nathanael. So the content is the same. What they offer are the same. One silver planter, one silver bowl, etc., actually is the same as the first day. And we can read it fast, because 12 days, the 12 tribes, actually they offer the same things to God. The third day, he led the son of Hul, leaders of the children of Zebulun. The third day is Zebulun. The fourth day, Reuben, the children of Reuben, Elisha, and they offer the same. And the fifth day, Shelumiel, the son of Zurishaddai, leader of the children of Simeon. The sixth day, Eliab, the son of Jerud, leaders of the children of Gad. And then, seventh day, Elishama, the son of Amulet, leader of the children of and also offer those same things. The eighth day, Gumalai, the son of Pershur, leader of the children of Malasha. And the ninth day is the children of Benjamin. And the tenth day is the children of Dan, Elisha, the son of Aminashada. And the 11th day, Pilgrim, the son of Ophrah, leader of the children of Asher. And the last, on the 12th day, the children of Naphtali. So 12 tribe leaders, every day they will offer the same things to God. One silver platter, one silver bowl, one gold pan, and more than 20 animals. According to the to different tribes they offer in different days. And verse 84, this was the dedication offering for the altar from the leaders of Israel when it was anointed. 12 silver platters, 12 silver bowls, and 12 gold pans. Each silver platter weighed 130. And verse 86, the 12 gold pans full of incense weighted 10 shekels piece according to the shekels of the century. All the gold of the pence weighed 120 shekels. So for the 12 gold pen, totally they are 120. They are weighted 10 shekels apiece. Do you feel strange? How come they can offer same things? If we say that we have to have an offering in New Crop 611, is it difficult for us to offer same things? If I ask you to find out 12 friends, how can they find the same weight of the silver platter, silver bowls? You have to find that they have also have 12 gold pen. The weight is the same, the star is the same. How come they can have totally same? So it is telling us when we offer, actually we can offer. We have the ability to offer. Actually, for the Israelites, they were slaves in the Egypt for 400 years. But for those things, actually, is very valuable. But all the tribe leader can offer those valuable things, and all of they also can offer for the same things. So for those things, actually, is get from the Egypt. But how come they can get it? It's because when they leave Egypt, actually they get the valuable things from Egypt. So when they leave Egypt, actually they are wealthy because they get all the valuable things. Just before they leave Egypt, actually they experienced the 10 prejudices, but actually so we can see that actually it's God protect them and God provide them. Even they experienced the hard time in Egypt, but God still provide them. So for today, actually it's the same. We should know that all we have is provided by God. And when we offer to God, is our heart to return to God again. And also, when we offer to God, we no need to compare with others. No matter we offer, but the most important is that we offer what we have. just like how they distributed the cards at the auction. We no need to compare with others because we have different roles. And for everything we offer to God, actually, it's come from God.
So,
when we saw the first day, the Judah saw that, oh, they have many good things to offer to God. And then every day, you will feel that, oh, our God is really amazing because God provide all the 12 tribe leader. The God treat different tribe is the same. God also provide the 12 tribe leader. So for verse 87, all the oxen for the burnt offering were 12 young bulls, the rams 12, the male lambs in their first year 12 with their grain offering, and the keys of the goats as a sin offering 12, and all the oxen for the sacrifice of peace offering were 24 bulls, the ram 60, the male goat 60, and the lambs in their first year 60. This was the dedication offering for the altar after it was anointed. So for all the offering of 12 tribe leaders, they offer many, many. These were what they offer, and they become the role model of the tribe. Maybe today when we read, we will think that it's repeat and repeat, and it's boring. But for here, for verse 84, to verse 88, they have to add it together and mention all the offerings, all the total numbers. Why it is so boring? Why have to repeat and repeat and then to wrote the total number? Maybe for us? Maybe we will say, oh, the first day is the Judah, and then we read clearly. And then maybe we wrote it clearly. But maybe we will just write the second day. And the second day over the same things, the third day is the children of Suberin, and they offer the same. Maybe we wrote the same. But the God wrote the Bible is clearly and repeat. So actually, in God's eyes, He precious what we offer. So when we offer to God, we not think about is to give it to Moses, but we really offer to God. For God, He record it very details and clearly, because the God really remember. what we offer. And all the tribe offer same things. So for this chapter, all the tribe is set apart and look God as the center of their life. We should have a thanksgiving heart and offer to God. And we know that what we have is also come from God. Although they are slaves in Egypt for 400 years, but God provide them and let them abundance. So when they offer to God, actually we can see that the grace for each tribe is same. When the tribe leaders offer to God, verse 89, now the Moses went into the tabernacle of meeting to speak with him. He heard the voice of one speaking to him from above the mercy seat that was on the ark of the testimony. From between the two separate, thus he spoke of them. When all the tribe leader offer what they have, the grand offering, the burnt offering, the sense offering, the peace offering, and then the God spoke to Moses in the tabernacle. When they finished all the offering, the voice of God speak to Moses. When all the tribe leader offered to God, and the presence of God is come down and spoke to Moses. For the God spoke to Moses, that means that God spoke to the Israelites. So this is the interaction between God and us. When we not compare, we look God as our center of our life. When we offer ourselves and the presence of God and the voice of God is in between us, and God will spoke to us and told us the will of God, and we can go forward. Numbers chapter 7. Today is a special day. The verse 1. They set the tabernacle and he anointed it and consecrated it. When the tabernacles finish, actually it's a special moment. We have to offer. All the brothers and sisters of Liu Crop 611. We also finish the tabernacles because we are keep waiting for the government to approve. We have the certificate for the government, and then we can have our own bank account. And then just before yesterday, when we leave church, we receive the mail from the government. So actually, New Crop 611 is a new start. We are a charity. And today we read that the tabernacle finished. So actually it's a new beginning of New Crop 611. So for today, this chapter, the Lord told us we have to offer all our tribe leader, we have to offer to God. When we offer to let God to speak to us again here, what we God want we offer as we have the ability. Today, the tabernacle of New Crop 611 was finished. So this is the day we have to offer to God again. And God is ready to come and to ready to speak to us. So for today, we also have to offer to God. So I invite brothers and sisters, you close your eyes and pray to God. You have to ask God what I should offer to God. We should open our spiritual eyes to see what God has done within us. For the epidemic, we saw God is the one protect us. Is it God also gave us the silver platter, the silver bowl, and the gold pen? For today, any spiritual gifts God gave us, maybe it's a different spiritual gift. For today, we also have to offer to God again. We have to bring our offer before God, and God also record in His book which leader what they offer to God. So for today, we can pray to God. We ask God what we should offer to the Lord. Especially in the epidemic, when we offer to God, the pillar of fire and the pillar of the cloud will be within us. And the grace and the mercy and the healing and the peace will come to us. Come to Hong Kong, come to Central, come to Shanghuan, and come to the whole earth. May God talk to us. May God speak to us now. If there is a move in your heart, you should have an offering to our church. You can put offerings to the bank account. Whatever you want to offer to God, may us willingly to offer to our God. And let God's presence can come down within among us. In Jesus' name, I bless all the brothers and sisters that they are willing to offer to God. May you record the names in heaven, just like you record those tribe leaders in the Bible. Everything they offer, you also record. Everything we offer, you also record in heaven. May you remembrance of all of us, and also may you open your heavens and provide all the brothers and sisters that they have the willing hearts to offer. May them have the peace, have grace and mercy and the ability from you. And hear our prayer in Jesus' name. Amen.